One of the highlights of going to a natural history museum is seeing the ancient, the extinct, the giant. Animals like dinosaurs are huge attractions. But the thing is, what you can see isn't entirely accurate. The color's all wrong. Some of the first dinosaur fossils were discovered in the 17th century. The discoverer thought it was part of a giant human. It wasn't for nearly two centuries that scientists would realize these bones belonged not to giants or dragons or pre-flood biblical creatures, but to multi-million-year-old animals called dinosaurs. Immediately, scientists started trying to gather and arrange bones and fragments into shapes and species, many of which they very famously got wrong. Putting bones together and knowing what a dinosaur looks like, it's a big leap. And that's where paleo art comes in. Imagine for a second, you have never seen a living human. No one has. But someone found a fossilized human skeleton. You don't know much about this animal or what it looked like on the outside. What does its skin look like? Does it have scales, fur, feathers? How does it walk? What color would the skin be? Would it be camouflaged? Someone who looks into this would be a paleo artist. These artists recreate extinct animals and plants, and they're the ones who decided what color dinosaur skin actually is, because to be honest, no one really knows. In the 19th century, paleo artists took dinosaur bones, and they likely used contemporary giants like elephants and rhinos, as well as reptiles, to inspire their idea of what animals would have that skeleton. This is how we got massive tail-dragging animals plodding hither and thither, not super accurate. Over time, scientists debated the finer points of these animals, like whether the head was held up above the body like a giraffe, or down at body level. How would these animals pump blood? How would their bones move if they had muscles? And over time, their drawings evolved. By the 1960s and 70s, dinosaurs had trimmed up. They were looking lighter and fitter and less gray and more colorful, but the skin. We've found fossilized skin, and it can tell us the texture, look, and feel of a dinosaur, but not color. Fossilization turns dino hide into stone, meaning no melanin, no melanosomes, no color. At least, not that we can see. In 2013, a Canadian scanning company took a textured bit of skin and bounced infrared wavelengths off of it, hoping to reveal the fossilized melanosomes inside, the bits of skin that hold color. They based this on earlier studies that tried to see if fossilized melanosome shapes could show us what color those melanosomes were. People really want to know this, y'all, and they're still researching. They've used this method successfully with well-preserved feathers, which dinosaurs were definitely covered in, and feathers could have had numerous colors, just like the birds that dinosaurs evolved into. But feathers are not skin color. Although it's maddening, scientists are still in the dark on this. The most accurate depiction of a dinosaur as it was built makes this tiny Psittacosaurus look cute and brown, which they found by lasers scanning the melanosomes in the skin. But the connection is debated, and as long as we're copying birds, coloring is often sex-specific. Females are brown, but males are flashy. That said, shading camouflage makes this one of the most accurate dinosaur depictions again, ever, for now. Ultimately, and for much of our depictive history of these animals, we've sort of been winging it, using data that's available at the time. But everything may change soon. In May 2017, a beautifully preserved fossilized nodosaur was revealed, found in a Canadian mine. It was basically mummified. This dinosaur is gorgeous. We got the hookup on these pics from the Royal Tyrrell Museum in Canada. If you notice, there's still no color, though. It just looks like stone. But they scanned the skin, and they found the presence of reddish pigments. Reddish! It's not much, but it's a start. In the end, the dinosaurs in your imagination were seeded by the imagination of paleo artists. Their work is what created dinosaurs in movies, museums, and theme parks. They fill in the skin on top of the skeletons, creating this rich tapestry of ancient life, and for now, it's a fictional one. Thanks to HelloFresh for sponsoring this episode. HelloFresh delivers quick, easy meals that you can do with step-by-step instructions even if you don't know how to cook. Trust me, because I did it. Okay, got my little card here. We're gonna do Turkish spiced salmon. Looks super easy, only six steps. HelloFresh is the meal kit delivery service that makes cooking more fun so you can focus on the whole experience, not just the final plate. My minced shallots there. Oh my God, I'm so excited.
Smells so good.
This is super easy. Meals are less than $10 each, and they now offer light spring meals and have just introduced breakfast options.
Oh, wow, look at that.
For $30 off your first week of deliveries, visit HelloFresh.com and enter Seeker30 when you subscribe. I talked to the famous paleontologist Jack Horner about what color dinosaur feathers were here. Since we don't know, what color do you think dinosaurs were? Tell us down in the comments, and please subscribe for more videos.